The name of the company was the East India Company. Commodities like cotton, silk, red spices like pepper, clove, cardamom and cinnamon attracted the English traders. They could buy goods at a very cheap price in India and carry them back to Europe and sell them at higher prices. The spices grown in India were in great demand in Europe.
Oh, so they came to India as businessmen. But how they became our rulers from businessmen?
Actually, in India, back in those days, the Rajas, Maharajas and Mughals were constantly fighting among themselves. This gave an opportunity to the British to start gaining control over India.
Oh, you mean to say that they became our kings from businessmen?
You are right. They not only became our rulers, but they also practiced unjust means and exploited our countrymen. People of all walks of life, be farmers, weavers, traders, everyone was unhappy and dissatisfied with the British rule.
So why didn't the Indians ask them to leave our country and go away?
That was not so easy. But yes, many young leaders got together and rose against the Britishers. We are proud of the freedom fighters who sacrificed their lives and fought for the freedom of our country. Their contributions are immeasurable.
I too have studied about some great freedom fighters of our country.
Absolutely correct. It was their sacrifice and love for their motherland without which the freedom we have today would not have been possible.
What sacrifice are you talking about? What did they do?
They played a great role in rousing a patriotic feeling among the Indians and uniting the Indians together to fight against the British. They did not even hesitate to give up their lives for the freedom of our country. This long struggle came to an end in the year 1947. On 15th of August, India, our motherland, got freedom from the British Raj.
Oh, now I understand why we celebrate this day with such pomp and show. Every school, college, government buildings, and in many other places, the Indian Tiranga is hoisted. The Prime Minister of India also hoists the national flag at the Red Fort.
They uphold the rich culture and tradition of our country.
I agree with you. It is indeed a day of great pride for Indians.
But we must remember, but it is not a one-day celebration. As Indians, young and old, each one of us must show the responsibility and carry out their duties sincerely. Only then we can call ourselves true independent. Jai Hind!
Jai Hind!
Jai Hind!
Buzzing with the spirit of nationalism, our tiny tots of kindergarten are all set to brighten our morning with Azadi Ki Dastaan.
Thank you.
Refreshing. खूब बहती है अमन की गंगा, बहने दो, मत फैलाओ देश में दंगा, रहने दो, लाल हरे रंग में मत बांटो सबको, मेरी छत पर एक तिरंगा रहने दो। ऐसी ही देशभक्ति की भावना से भरी हुई एक कविता, जब भारत आजाद हुआ था, कुछ बच्चे आप सभी के समक्ष प्रस्तुत करने जा रहे हैं।
आजादी का राज हुआ था, वीरों ने कुर्बानी दी थी, तब भारत आजाद हुआ था। भगत सिंह ने फांसी ली थी, इंदिरा जी का जनाजा हुआ था। इस मिट्टी की खुशबू ऐसी थी, तब खून की आंधी बहती थी।
वतन का जज्बा ऐसा था, जो सबसे लड़ता जा रहा था। लड़ते लड़ते जाने गई थी, भारत आजाद हुआ था।
फिरंगियों ने कुछ छोड़ा था, इस देश के रिश्तों को तोड़ा था।
Yoga preserves our sovereignty and reminds us of the power in our potential. Cultivating a healthy coordination of mind and body, here's presenting the youth of today, reinstilling its importance in liberating ourselves from all negativity.
प्यारा आओ हम मिलके बोले, अब तो यारा अपना जहां है सबसे प्यारा। जनगणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल वंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे